Heart attacks kill more Oklahomans than cancer or any other disease.
This year alone, the CDC estimates nearly 11,000 people in our state will die from a heart attack. And part of surviving a heart attack is knowing your risk.
Now a doctor says that the risk may have everything to do with your blood. And Eyewitness News 5's Dariel Snipes tells us why sticky blood may mean you are at greater risk for a heart attack.
Henry and Hazel Dubé have been married for 63 years. Both have heart problems. Henry has had a double coronary bypass, Hazel a heart attack and 5 stents.
I had no indication other than this enormous pain. And I said, it can't be enough. Oh no, I would never have a heart attack. Well, I did.
But there is a significant difference between Hazel and Henry. She has sticky blood, and he doesn't. The only reason they know that is Dr. Paul Gerbel. Sticky blood, in his terminology, is platelet aggregation.
So the platelets literally will stick to one another, they'll stick to the vessel wall, and they'll form a plug, and that plug will obstruct the blood flow in the artery in the heart.
Dr. Gerbel believes that platelet aggregation, or sticky blood, is the primary cause of heart attacks and the major cause of death in people with heart disease. His research on platelets has been in dozens of well-known medical journals, and he's presented his findings all over the world. He says knowing how sticky your platelets are is the holy grail in heart research. He even goes as far to say, if you don't have sticky blood, you'll never have a heart attack.
So this does what exactly?
It will actually measure the strength of the clot.
Dr. Gerbel and his team are developing a simple test that could be used around the world to reliably test blood stickiness, kind of like cholesterol tests.
We measure the cholesterol in everyone with vascular disease, but yet the pivotal event that kills the patient, which is the platelet aggregate formation in the artery, we don't do anything to assess.
Here's what Hazel's blood looks like. See how the platelets stick together? And here's what happens after she was given an experimental drug Dr. Gerbel is working on called PRT-128. He says some people simply don't respond to the two workhorse drugs they now have, Plavix and aspirin.
I think the way we blindly administer these very important drugs without determining whether they're working or not, given all the research out there now, we need to do a lot better.
And he hopes to change that, maybe within the next 5 years, so that one day people like Hazel and Henry and millions of others will know if they have sticky blood and what to do about it. Dariel Snipes, Eyewitness News 5.
So if you'd like to learn a little bit more about preventing heart attacks and how to have a heart-healthy holiday season, we've added some help to our website. Just look under the As Seen on 5 section of KOCO.com.